This video is brought to you by Straight Goods News, Canada's alternative online news source. Visit straightgoods.ca.
...work is because I think we should listen to the counterparty that you say you want to work with. So you're saying that what we should do is to joint nominating meetings with Liberals to find a common opponent against the Conservatives.
That's exactly.
And when you listen to the Liberals, what they tell you is that what they believe would happen on a proposal like that is about half of their vote would vote Conservative. And so what you're actually doing with your proposal is you're electing more Conservatives. But I'm speaking to you now as a Quebec New Democrat. At a time when we were getting 1% and 2% of the vote, we never gave up. We never said, wow, New Democrats can't win. We said, the day will come when we will win.
Absolutely.
And I don't know why a British Columbian in one of the most successful sections we've got in our party would say we can't win.
Absolutely.
New Democrats
not.
Can win. As ourselves.
All right, Mr. Singh, I'd like to give you the opportunity. Go ahead.
Yeah, that's all right. Thank you. Well, what we have to make sure that we do is that we have to make sure that we have a clear message that we have to articulate to the voters. Currently, the Conservatives have a clear message, but that clear message is based on trying to divide people, not just on a rural-urban base, but also regionally across Canada and also different economic classes. So what we have to make sure we do is when we articulate this message that it is very clear. And in this regard, I also share the concerns that other people have regarding Nathan's plan. Because what happens is that you muddy the waters, in effect. Because we know that if we're running against Liberals in one particular riding, but then you're running effectively with them in another, and sometimes those ridings, just because of geographical circumstance, may be side by each, you know, it's going to cause a huge amount of difficulty from a campaigning perspective, and I don't think we should be putting ourselves in that
hole. And I just, you know, you had mentioned many times that this would be a one-time offer, the joint nominations, right?
That's right.
And, you know, frankly, you know, that sounds to me more like a ShamWow commercial. This isn't about a one-time offer. This is about our party. This is about our roots. And what you're doing, really, is you're saying to people who voted New Democrat all their lives, not people who are members, who they voted New Democrat all their lives, is we're going to take that choice away from you. I think what it will do, it will divide people at the riding level.
With your proposal is it's going to divide people at the riding level.
Here's the challenge you have. Absolutely entitled to opinions around such a proposal, but you're not entitled to your own facts on the proposal. And the facts are this.
What facts?
Well, that when New Democrats worked with Liberals in Parliament in 2005 to create a budget, we cooperated. Canadians responded positively.
In Parliament, when not at the riding level, though.
When
not
we worked
level.
With Liberals, again, to attempt to form a coalition government, Canadians, and in particular Quebec, responded very positively.
Absolutely.
So is it a Canadian value, and do Canadians appreciate it when parties attempt to work together? Absolutely.
But not
yeah,
at
but
the...
Nathan, the thing is this.
I mean, not at the riding level. You're talking about the riding level.
Except Mr. Top wants to get in on this. Go ahead.
Well, I was there for all of that stuff, and it was all good. It was all the work of the Lord, no doubt about it, and we were advancing our agenda. But you know what? When we were talking to the Liberals at the time, they were talking about what their own folks made of these proposals. And yes, it was a pretty good sell for Liberal voters that we cooperated in Parliament, but you're wrong if you believe that through a gadget, through this proposal, that 100% of the Liberal vote is going to vote for a joint candidate unless it's never a New Democrat. And so that's what I can't accept about your proposal.
It's not even a assumption that we...
But exactly as Paul is saying, that what we're doing is we're taking away the choice of New Democrats riding by riding. We don't...
Absolutely
my point
not.
To you is
that's
you don't have to be so pessimistic.
No, but let's be clear, because this is being misrepresented by the robocalls going out. The facts are this, that the decision actually is made by New Democrats. So this idea about robbing New Democrats, what I know about this about New Democrats...
But no, people who vote New Democrats...
We as a spirit and a party, in our tradition, in our past, and I hope in our future, are able to understand that we face challenges that this country faces with a majority Stephen Harper government.
So let's defeat him by...
have been a nightmare.
Let's,
8 years
let's
will be an
do
absolute
that. Nathan, why don't we have trust in our own party? Why don't we have trust in our own party, riding by riding, building up our grassroots, and then winning? What you're talking about is distraction. Wait, maybe in 3 years we'll do it. Let's get on with the job right now. This is urgent. We need to do it right now,
yes,
and we have to organize our grassroots, not the Liberal grassroots.
All right, folks.